Hey, how you doing? Alright, here we are again doing another reaction video. And this time, so we've already done top 10 forgotten boy bands. So now we're gonna do another video by Miss Mojo, top 10 best forgotten girl groups. So let's see what they got going on. In the thumbnail is Nicole Scherzinger. I know she was in the group called Eden's Crush. That was on a show, Pop Stars, where it was basically American Idol before. Or no, maybe it was after American Idol. I don't remember. I'm sure they'll tell us. So let's get into it.
Get ready to feel some serious nostalgia you might not have even known you had. Welcome to Ms. Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 forgotten girl groups.
I still listen to this song.
Before we begin, we publish new content every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. For this list, we're looking at those girl bands that were otherwise lost in the mists of time.
I don't forget them.
Here, they will not be forgotten.
I think I have this song on my iPod. Nobody's Angel. They were on Boy Meets World. I remember that because I had Boy Meets World on DVD. All seven seasons. But I remember they were on Boy Meets World.
Underscoring movies from the late 90s and early 2000s, such as The Princess Diaries and The Parent Trap, seem to be a niche for this group. And for the time they were together, they were quite good at it. They even guest starred on an episode of Boy Meets World and in the TV movie Model Behavior. Though they were only together for a short time, their music will always ring out when we're feeling nostalgic.
I don't remember any of their music, though.
Number 9, Sugar Babes. Like so many girl groups, Sugar Babes lost their members along the way. They stand out from the pack, however, in the fact that they slowly lost all of their members and replaced them one by one. Altogether having 6 UK chart-topping singles and 18 songs to hit the top 10 in the UK. Only the Spice Girls had done better. Don't worry about the original members of the group, though. They came together and made a group of their own. Mattia, Keisha, Siobhan, or MKS for short.
Never heard of them.
Number 8, M2M. This duo started making music together when they were preteens.
Sounds like something that would be in a Disney Channel movie.
Known as Marion and Marit in their native country of Norway, but after signing a record deal with Atlantic Records, they changed their name to M2M and went on to release their most well-known song to date in Don't Say You Love Me. However, after their second album, the two sadly went their separate ways. Larson later attributed this to the pair's progressively differing tastes, stating that she wanted to make really good pop music and Marion wanted to go rock. And that's exactly what they did, putting out some pretty catchy solo work. Number 7, Black. Who could
Black?
Forget the magic
that's
of
right.
TLC and the tragic loss of Left Eye? Well, before she died, Left Eye found similar magic in this group, which she produced.
Bring it out to me.
Right from the start, Black proved themselves as a force to be reckoned with. Their debut album went platinum, and they were named the 1999 Billboard 4th Best New Artist of the Year.
Oh, 4th.
Circles like a figure eight.
The following year, they guest starred as Gabrielle Union's backup in the fun and funny rom-com Bring It On. Unfortunately, just like TLC, they suffered from the tragic loss of a member. In 2012, Natina Reid died in a car accident just as they were
just like
a 2012 comeback. Number 6, Bewitched. The story of Bewitched
remember this from Smokehouse, I think.
The Irish quartet were first brought together by a sisterly bond between two of its members and the love
song,
of singing.
Though. Not the group. The song.
Say what you say to me.
Say what you. 1997, they hit the international stage with hit single after slam hit single. However, for reasons unknown, after recording their third album, their record company decided not only to not release the record, but to drop the band altogether. Since 2012, though, the group has been making a slow comeback, going on tour with other underrated pop groups and releasing
an EP. Who is this? Why do they look like they do drugs? Two of them, anyway.
Play. The Swedish group lost members and replaced them a few times.
Play. I've heard of them. They have a Christmas
active.
Song that I like, and that's it. She's like 10.
Put out some catchy earworms, such as Us Against the World from their first album and Famous from their latest.
Song.
And opening for A-listers like Destiny's Child. Due to infighting, though, in 2011, the group went their separate ways for reasons unknown to the public and were allegedly no longer on speaking terms. It's a shame we won't ever get to press play on their new EP.
Ugh. I've heard that they sang that song before, the Cheetah Girls.
Number 4, All Saints. Another UK-based group that gave the Spice Girls a run for their money.
Ooh.
All Saints' single Never Ever is only seconded in that part of Europe in terms of sales by Wannabe. And we can easily hear why. You try not tapping your toes to those silky vocals paired with that rhythmic bass.
I got nothing.
Their other singles did not do nearly as well. They still know how to sing a catchy tune. And despite two hiatuses in their still quietly thriving career, the girls clearly never lost a beat. Number 3, 3LW. Saved by the fans, briefly at least.
I don't think anybody really forgot them, though. And only because Adrian is on the reel.
And would have dropped just as quickly had it not been for their adoring public. In the lead up to their second album, rumors began to circulate that
just ain't nobody checking for
them. But a fan campaign forced Epic Records to reconsider. Sadly, though, one member would soon leave the group, and the other two would eventually join Disney's The Cheetah Girls.
Leave the group, she
and
got
so
kicked.
The final album was never released.
Nicole Scherzinger.
Before competition shows like American Idol and The Voice.
It was before American Idol.
TV
okay.
Channel. The early 2000s, a time when a show called Pop Stars came into our
on
living
WB.
Room by way
That's
of
right.
the WB. This competition show sorted through hundreds and hundreds of hopefuls, cutting them down to the group of five that would become Eden's crush.
I remember this song too. Do it back.
Unfortunately, it was not meant to be.
I remember the song.
After only one album and with their debut single topping charts, their record company closed down and the band broke up. Fret not though, group member Nicole Scherzinger went on to form the Pussycat Dolls. Don't you wish your girlfriend was wrong like me?
Don't you wish your girlfriend was fun like me? I'm thinking about Norbit.
All the lyrics for our final pick, here are a few honorable mentions.
Wait a minute. Don't do that to En Vogue. No. Yeah, they were really good. They just didn't have enough hit songs.
Number 1, Dream. In 1998, Dream. Record label Bad Boy Records signed a girl group that would come to be known around the world as Dream. Teens was handpicked by a
but they were completely forgotten.
Rose to international fame.
Completely.
Their songs about the darker side of love, underscored with upbeat tunes, spoke to the masses. Their singles, He Loves You Not and This Is Me, took top spots on several charts. However, the band soon lost traction on the charts, and in 2003, they were dropped from Bad Boy. Nonetheless, when one of their songs comes on, you're sure to remember the melody, and their lyrics are just as relevant today. You agree with our picks? Check out these other great clips from Ms. Mojo and subscribe for new videos every day.
Okay, so if you watch the video that I reacted to for the top 10 forgotten boy bands, then you would have seen that at the concert I went to 3 years ago, Dream was one of the acts. That's why I was like, Dream, hey. But yeah, I didn't really forget them. I'm sure the general public did. But yeah, it's a pretty accurate list. Except for En Vogue. Kill yourself. Because En Vogue is not forgotten.
Ever.
Until next time. Who am I, Walter Cronkite? Till next video.